Força de alegria. Energy. Spirit and spirit come together in oneness. Our problem that faces us is disunity. And this is why it is good for us to come together in unity and support our own self.
Yeah.
Everyone that has been successful in the world outside here, whether they are Chinese, Indians, European, they are doing it in unity. The reason why we are not successful in whatever we are doing outside here is because we have no unity among ourselves. So it is good for us to see the beginning of things to come. When I say the beginning of things to come, what do I really mean? You see, everything is energy. Everything. Everything is everything. Oftentimes we say that, but do we understand it? Do we understand it? The wall is energy. It's not solid. If I know the tone that I can utter, that wall can come apart. This is why you have some people that utter a song where they hit certain pitch, glass, mirrors break.
Yeah.
That is how powerful energy is. But we're all energy. Because we're all made up of millions of billions and trillions of subatomic particles. Vibrating in unity, in harmony. So, if we can sit here make certain mantras and certain chants, you'll be surprised that collective energy, anywhere we direct it, it becomes very powerful. But because we are disunited, in the sense that some of us are praying with our behind to the east, or behind to the west, to the north, to the south, we do not understand that praise our conquerors, gods, and all the people to give them strength. But to praise our own, really and truly, to give us energy and life. And it is this that I and I need now as a people. The collectivity of this energy that we can direct it. Even before you go to bed at night, your thoughts are very important. You know, extremely important. If you can program your mind before you go to your bed, you'll be surprised when you see that before tomorrow. Program it when you get up in the morning, and you'll be surprised to see what your day is like outside here. We've been thought foolishly to bust up our knees and sit and pray for things to come and wait for it. No. Our ancient ancestors who built pyramids, invented mathematics, and gave medicine and all these civilizations to the world, they didn't do that. We definitely did exact science. And that exact science that we dealt with was something that is able to direct whatever we want outside here. But because we've lost that energy, we've lost that memory, we're suffering from a thing called menticide. Menticide means that we've forgotten who we are, where we're coming from. So therefore, our cultural modality is out of sync. It is important for us to reclaim Sankofa. Go back and fetch it. Go back and fetch that which we have lost. Go back and fetch that which we have displaced. Go back and fetch that which has been taken away from us. And by doing that, I and I can come once again and rise. And if our ancestors of the Big Pyramid invented arithmetic, their civilization to the world, then, can you imagine what I and I can do in this time if collectively we are working together as one? So, let the energies of our ancestors be with us. When I say that, I don't want anybody here to say, wait, I don't think this is my job. No. Our ancestors dwell within us. Because the blood, my blood, coming from my mother, which coming from her mother, right the way through. You understand what I'm saying to you? So, when I say the ancestors, they're with us three way. They're not on our way. So it's for us to know and realize, really and truly, that when we call upon our ancestors, you have to go back to the foundation of time. We have all the information about this religion. And everything we've ever done, and everything we should ever be doing, you know, is right here in my presence. Give thanks and praise. May the ancestors bless you. Amen. 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 Amen